Joining me now is Republican Congressman Charlie Dent of Pennsylvania. Congressman, good morning to you.
Good morning, Victor. Great to be with you.
Good to have you. Let me first start with this fiery statement from the former CIA director, John Brennan, in reaction to this firing of Andrew McCabe. When the full extent of your venality, moral turpitude, and political corruption becomes known, you will take your rightful place as a disgraced demagogue in the dustbin of history. You may scapegoat Andy McCabe, but you will not destroy America. America will triumph over you. That apparently directed toward the President of the United States. Your reaction to that?
Well, here's my reaction to the whole McCabe thing. First, we haven't seen the Inspector General report, so I can't speak to whether or not Mr. McCabe was completely truthful or was he evasive in that investigation. I simply don't know. But this firing looks a bit forced, a bit rushed. Candidly, it looks like retribution and a bit vindictive. And I think it's unfortunate. The man said he was resigning. And, you know, and on a Friday night before his 50th birthday, you know, he's fired to take away his pension. I don't like the optics of this. I really don't. And I have to tell you, it looks like the attorney general may have been browbeaten into this. He's been publicly humiliated and shamed by the president on multiple occasions. And I just don't think this bodes well. And one other thing I wanted to say, too, you know, we just had a special election on Tuesday, and all this continuing chaos and drama that we're seeing with the Tillerson firing, the McCabe firing, you know, Stormy Daniels, all this stuff. This is having an impact on Republicans down ballot. If people didn't get the message on Tuesday, I hope they get it now.
So do you expect to, in the context of what you say is residual impact on Republicans down ballot, should we hear from Paul Ryan, should we hear from Leader McConnell on this specifically, and Stormy Daniels, and the firing of Tillerson, and all of these other elements?
Well, look, I've told my Republican colleagues on multiple occasions that you know, we're running into a major storm, a big-time hurricane force wind. And that, you know, we are going to be defined by all these issues swirling around us unless we're able to develop our own brand and our own identity in our own districts. This is a five-alarm fire. And, you know, we simply just can't dismiss the election on Tuesday, you know, to local events. That would be, just to say this is all about the candidates, I think would be an overstatement and simply not the case. It's about these larger issues of this toxic political environment we find ourselves in. And that's my message to leadership. That's my message to my colleagues.
What do you think the message is to the law enforcement community? The president, in this tweet that Abby just shared with us, called this a great day for the men and women of the FBI, a great day for democracy. What do you think the message is that this sends to that agency?
Well, it seems that the president, you know, he's been battling with the FBI and certain elements of the intelligence community for some time. Like I said, I don't think it's in the interests of the Republican Party, which traditionally has been the party of law enforcement, to be engaged in this kind of a battle with the FBI. Again, I always had the sense that the rank-and-file FBI had a pretty high regard for Mr. Comey. I don't know what their relationship was with Mr. McCabe. I hadn't heard terrible things. So I guess the point I guess I'm making is that Comey and McCabe seem to have some respect within the FBI by the rank and file. So I'm not sure really what the message is that the president's sending there.
Deputy Director McCabe was questioned as part of the House Intelligence Russia probe. He will very likely have to speak to Robert Mueller as part of the special counsel's investigation into Russian meddling and any potential collusion there with the campaign. The Attorney General recused himself from all matters involving Russia. In the context of McCabe's role in these investigations, should he have recused himself from this decision to fire McCabe?
I'll say the Attorney General Sessions was absolutely right in recusing himself on the Russian probe. I mean, all the documentation and all the rules that I had read suggested he did the absolute right thing recusing himself. You know, should he recuse himself in the case of firing of McCabe? Well, to the extent that I can't speak to the extent to which Mr. McCabe is involved in the Russia investigation, but it would seem to me that the Attorney General is in his rights to fire in this case. I think that's probably, whether it's the right decision or not is a completely different matter. But I think he was within his rights to terminate him.
All right. Congressman Charlie Dent, always good to have you.